نستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. أما بعد يقول سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم في سورة آل عمران بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال في سورة النساء يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا وهو يقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما الحمد لله. After making an introduction from the Kitab of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after praising Him and after seeking forgiveness in Him and seeking refuge in Him and seeking His help, then I went on to recite a few ayats from the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He commands the believing people to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to have fear in Him, taqwa. To have taqwa and to fear and to obey Allah. Wherever you are, if you're home and in your car and if you're in a place of worship and not a place of worship, and it reminds me of one hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he says, "Ittaqi Allah haythu ma kunt, wa itbi' as-sayyi'ata al-hasana tamhuha, wa khaliqi an-nas bi khuliqin hasan." And in this hadith, what we can get translated from it is that we are commanded in this hadith to fear Allah wherever you are. Not with this person or that person in this place or that place, but fear Allah wherever you find yourself alive. Fear Allah and give Him His right. And then he says to follow a good deed. I mean, follow a bad deed with a good deed. And have husnul khuluq, good behavior. Honestly good behavior, not good behavior that is to show off or that is a facade. But have good behavior that is with truth. And that is from the Kitab and the Sunnah. Going on from this point, inshallah, my message to you all today will be about the noblest of all sciences. Inshallah, I will start it in Arabic and then it will be in English. Wa bi'idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ashraful ulum. Al-ilmu bi asma'illahi al-husna. Ashraful ulum li ta'luqiha bi ma'rifatillahi azza wa jal. Fasharful ilmi min sharafil ma'lum. ومعرفتها تقود إلى الإيمان به قال سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الفاتر إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء ومعرفتها ومنها معرفة أسمائه أصل العلوم وأساس الإيمان لأن العلم قبل القول والعمل وَمَا فَرَضَ اللَّهُ عَلَى خَلْقِهِ تَوْحِيدُهُ فَإِذَا عَرَفَهُ النَّاسَ عَبْدُهُ وَحْدَهُ قَالَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ فِي سُورَةِ مُحَمَّدٍ وَمَعْرِفَةُ اللَّهِ بِأَسْمَائِهِ الْحُسْنَى تَزِيدُ فِي الْإِيمَانِ وَالْيَقِينِ وَتَحْقِيقِ التَّوْحِيدِ وَمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَجِدَ لَذَّةَ الْعِبَادَةِ فَأَقْرِبُ طَرِيقٍ إِلَى ذَلِكَ أَنْ يَتَدَبَّرَ صِفَاتِهِ تَعَالَى وَأَسْمَائِهِ الْوَارِدَةِ فِي الْقُرْآنِ وَصَحِيحِ السُّنَّةِ. So inshallah, what I was saying here was that the noblest of all sciences is the knowledge of Allah's glorious names, His glorious names and His glorious attributes. That this knowledge leads to the direct belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And a knowledge such as this is noble since it requires nobility. And from this nobility, the abd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stands in shock, or he stands in amazement, or he stands in awe of his creator azza wa jal. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. And he says, verily, of those who stand in awe and amazement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those who have knowledge about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. True knowledge. Knowledge that is not falsified by the media or by unauthorized sources. Okay? And then the next portion is that this knowledge, and of this knowledge, is the knowledge of Allah's names. It is the basis of the sciences, and it is the foundation of the faith. The foundation of your faith. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the knowledge comes before actions and words. That if you're a person who acts without knowledge, just, you know, saying something that there is no knowledge or no authenticity behind it, then you are committing a wrong thing. If you say something that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not say, then you're lying upon him. And if you do something that has not been revealed in the Quran or in the Sahih Sunnah, then it is rejected. As we know in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he says, "Man amila amalan laysa alayhi amruna fahuwa radd." He says in his hadith, or kama qala an-nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that whoever does an action without the authorization or without being authentic or commanded from kitab and sunnah, then it is rejected. And then another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said to us, "Man kadhiba alayhi muta'ammidan falyatabawwa maq'adahu min an-nar." He says in this hadith that whoever lies upon the Prophet intendingly, purposefully, do not research, take whatever people say, and then make up stories about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then his seat, or he said, this person should go take his seat in the fire. So, brothers and sisters, it is very keen and it's very important that we must seek knowledge at every age and at every moment that we get. It is not going to harm you. Many people say, you know, we have jobs, we don't have the time, you know, kada wa kada. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the wealth and the brain to do so. Seek the knowledge. أو كما قال النبي وَمَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَلْتَمِسُ فِيهِ عِلْمًا سَهَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever strives and paths a road to seeking knowledge, Allah will make his path to Jannah very easy. And then moving on to the last statement in my address, inshallah, where I said that knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, glorious names and attributes, it leads to correct iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and certainty, al-yaqeen, in that belief. Not just having the belief, but being certain and know for sure. Not just say, I believe, I just think, but know for sure for yourself. And it strives to establish firm tawheed, aqeedah, of the Quran and from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not the aqeedah that has been fabricated. Not the aqeedah of different religions taking from here and taking from there, but the aqeedah of Islam, and only that.
Because that is only what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. Then after that,
this is the quickest way, by seeking this knowledge of Allah's names and attributes, this is the quickest way of being able to attain this achievement by the glory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then to reflect upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's beautiful names and attributes. From the authentic ayahs of the Quran and from the authentic sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, as closing out inshallah wa bi'idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I urge every person from
the age of maturity, from the age of understanding, no matter what your background is, no matter what your race is, no matter how you were born or how you were raised, seek ilm. And as we know, that knowledge sets you free. Because when you don't have knowledge,
you're mentally enslaved. But the Quran and Sunnah is the emancipation for all of mankind to leave that mental slavery. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did for me, coming from an apostolic Christian family, being one of the first youth in my whole family to come to Islam, not having any idea about the Arabic language. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He blessed me with this beautiful experience of al-Islam. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may continue to allow us to remain upon the haqq and to die upon the haqq, and that we all may meet again in Jannatul Firdaus A'la. Wa Allahumma salli wa sallam ala nabiyyil kareem wa ala azwajihi wa dhurriyatihi wa awliya'ul mu'minin. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallahu khairan, AbduRasheed. Now, the next program, I need permission from the timekeepers.